Hello, lovelies. Welcome. What's gluten-free, dairy-free, vegan, sugar-free, nut-free, keto-friendly, and high in protein? I know most of the recipes on this channel. Today, I wanted to share with you my lentil stuffed peppers. Yes, you know I love lentils. And I use them for lots of ingredients, including bread and cookies and pancakes. And if you haven't seen all my videos on them, I will show you a link. This is super easy to do. I'm going to show you my version of these. They're very simple, easy, and the meat eaters enjoy them too. That's big for me because not everybody is vegan. Okay, so what we're gonna do first is get the peppers. You're going to pick any color you choose or multiple colors, and then you're going to wash them and cut them. I like to cut them vertically so I get two stuffed peppers out of each pepper. You are welcome to use just one and cut off the cap, and then you can even save the cap for decor, but I like to cut them in half. So you only need about 2 to 3 peppers, and then you're gonna cut them up, and that way you have 4 to 6. So grab maybe that package that they sell at the market of the 3 peppers together. That way I have more stuffed peppers. Okay, so then I slice open these. I put them in the oven just for a little bit. 2 cups of green lentils and 3 cups of water. And then we're gonna put the lentils in the water on the saucepan, a medium heat. Just leave those there. Then we're gonna go ahead and get the basmati rice. I use organic basmati rice. I actually use the frozen. Then after about 20 minutes, check on your lentils. You can add salt, you can add a little olive oil if you'd like. And then we're gonna mix that together, and I put it in a casserole dish in the oven, 350 for another like 25, 35 minutes, depending upon your stove. Okay, now we're gonna work on the tomato sauce. So you can use tomato sauce from scratch. I have some recipes on my channel if you're interested, or you are welcome to use jarred sauce. Again, if you wanna keep it simple, I use a nice jar sauce from Trader Joe's. There's another one that I like from Whole Foods. Again, I don't like a lot of citric acid. Tomatoes are already high in glutamate, so naturally occurring glutamate. So I try not to get any natural flavors or citric acid. Keep that in mind. Okay, so optional add-ins. Basically, I use whatever's in my house. So sometimes I use more sauteed peppers and onions and garlic. And then I add some olive oil, about 2 tablespoons of olive oil, saute them in the pan and let them get nice and savory. Add your salt, add your pepper. And if you have basil, we're just getting into the spring season and we just started our garden, so I'm super excited. I used basil that was frozen. Of course, if you have fresh basil, that is awesome. Black pepper, olive oil, salt again. Now for the fall, this is a really nice mixture. It's a little more time intensive, but again, it's whatever you have in the fridge. So I mix pumpkin, sweet potatoes, basically butternut squash and or pumpkin and sweet potatoes. Then I add a nice cabbage mixture that I get from Trader Joe's. I also do kale and carrots. And it's really yummy and savory. And then I put them in the pretty orange and yellow peppers and you get a really pretty dish. So this is the mixture that I make. Again, I'll add some nuts. And then I get those veggie tots from Trader Joe's. They're organic veggie tots. And I mash them up and put them in the mixture. And it's like a stuffing inside of the sweet potato. And those are organic and vegan and gluten-free. So check those out for the fall time. If you're watching this in the autumn and you want to make something really yummy and pretty, try that. So this mixture goes inside the peppers. Now back to our traditional easy peasy peppers. Here we go. We're going to get those peppers that we prepared, get the mixture of the lentils and the rice and mix them together, and then stuff the peppers with them. So you're gonna get all the mixtures that you created of the lentils, the rice, and anything else that you had on hand. I used some peppers and onions, and then I just put them inside these peppers and put them right in the oven. You can drizzle some extra olive oil on it. If you don't want to use olive oil, that's fine. You can spray them with a little bit of water to give them a steam bath. Put them in the oven for about 30 minutes, 350 degrees. And then they are done. That was so simple. So now I'm going to take them out and plate them. And I added some Kalamata olives on top. They're not only delicious and savory, but they look pretty. So then I added a little bit more sauce on top of it, and I added some Bragg seasoning or any other herbs that you might have on hand. Sometimes I'll put a nice fresh piece of basil. But I love this Bragg's. If you don't use this, it's awesome, awesome, awesome. Grab it, keep it in your house. It goes well with everything. It takes the flavors to a whole new level. Okay, so sometimes I like to have this myself because I'm always looking for ways to include extra greens in my meals. I'll get arugula, put it in the oven with a little bit of olive oil and a little bit of water, put it in there for about 350 or in a saucepan. Then I take it out. I don't leave it in for long, maybe 10 minutes, just to get it a little bit warm so it's not a cold salad. It's easier to digest that way. And it's also good too if there's any impurities that you didn't get when you washed the food, that it will kill it. So then I just add my peppers right in there. So I use this a bunch of different ways. And yes, my husband eats it and he's not a big fan of my vegan dishes. And my kids, yes, they love it. All right, judges, on the menu tonight we have stuffed vegan peppers. Here we go, pumpkin. What are we thinking? Do you think you're gonna like that? You could look a little more excited. Well, most of the time, it depends on the mood. Anyway, give it a try. Let me know your thoughts or questions, and I will put some links below. This is a nice, quick, easy meal. You can also use it as a side dish. By the way, guys, I am Rebekah, and this is Spiced. I love to do gluten-free meals and healthy meals and all that stuff and reviews. So if you're interested in seeing more of this, then give me a like and a subscribe. Bye. I love the smell.